back to my channel. So today I'm going to be showing you guys how to make this layered dress, but this time around it will have a button in front with a shirt neckline, a collar. So the first thing you're going to do, we're going to start with the top part. So to cut that, what you're going to do is to fold your fabric into two, and then you're going to go ahead and start putting in your measurements. So the width I'm using here is my bust divided by four. So my bust is 42 divided by 4 is going to be 10.5 plus extra 1 inch, that's 11.5. so that's the width I have here. So you're going to go ahead and measure your shoulder to waist. So the shoulder to waist I'm working with is going to be 17.5 plus extra one, that's going to be 18.5. the 1 inch is for the half an inch for joining the shoulder and half an inch for joining this bottom part to the body of the dress. So now I've marked my line, so now we're going to start putting in our measurements. So first thing I'm going to do is to start from the shoulder. My shoulder measurement divided by 2 is going to be 8. So my shoulder is 16 divided by 2 is 8. So now I'm going to come down, putting my armhole 20 divided by 2, that's going to be 10. I'm going to go ahead and mark that here. And then the next thing I'm going to do is to go ahead and give it a curve. So this is going to be my back body. So I'm starting with the back panel, because remember, this is a button down. So next thing I'm going to do is to go ahead and mark 3 inches here, and then come down by 1 inch for the back neckline, connect it this way, and then come down here 1 inch on my shoulder slant, and then connect it this way, and then come down here. So this here is already my bust measurement. Bust measurement divided by 4 plus 1. So that's exactly the width I'm using. So no need to check it again. And then my waist is 36 divided by 4 is 9 plus extra 2, that's going to be 11. So I'm going to mark that here and connect these 2 points. So guys, I've cut out the pattern. So you see, I went ahead and cut everything out, and then I cut 2 of it. One is going to be my front panel, one is going to be my back panel. I know you'll be thinking, so how am I going to get the placket for the button? We'll still come to that. So I just cut out the same thing, and as you can see, I've split the front panel into two. So you see, the front panel is now into two here. But one thing I'm going to do now is to bring down my neckline in by 3 inches for the front. So for the front, you see my back neckline, this is it here. So, but since I use this to trace this, that's why the neckline is the same. But since this is going to be my front, I'm going to just extend it to 3 inches down, right? And then curve it. So this is going to be my new front neckline here. So I'm going to go ahead and cut this out. And then, so guys, I've cut this out. For the armhole, I came in half an inch, halfway through the armhole, came in half an inch here. This is just how to, just like how you normally cut your normal bodies. I'm going to go ahead and cut this out here. Is, let's say the if you want to get your measurement for the bottom, all you have to do is to subtract your half length, which is your shoulder to waist, from the full length. The full length can be your shoulder to the floor, shoulder to your ankle, it depends on you. So you're going to subtract this from this full length, and then that's how you're going to get this, which is the bottom layer. So let's say what you're working with now is 40 for the bottom layer. You can, to determine the bottom of your flay, no one can tell you like how to divide it. It's left to you, the design you're working with, the style you're working with. So let's say whatever you want to use as the bottom of your dress, this part of your dress here, this bottom part here, you can always go ahead and divide the layers yourself. So you can, if it's 40 that you're working with for the bottom, you can do 10 10 10. If it's 4 layers, you can also do maybe 8 8, and then 12 12. It depends on you how you want to distribute the flay. So with that being said, how you're going to, so whatever you decide to use as the layers here, you remember you're going to, if you decide to use 10 10 10 10 for the 4 layers, remember to always add plus 1 for the first layer, plus 1 plus 1 plus 1.5 for the final layer. This is because you need half an inch at the top part here and half an inch at the bottom part here to join this and this together. And then for this one here, you also need another half an inch here and half an inch here. So half an inch here will join to this one, half an inch here will join to this bottom layer that will also come with its own half an inch. So for each part, you need about 0.5 0.5 and then 0.5, if that makes any sense. So that's why I said whatever length. So if you add 1 inch to this one now, is instead of the 10, let's say you're working with 40 and you want it to be 10 10 10, so instead of 10 here, what you have is 11. Instead of 10 here, another 11. Instead of 10 here, another 11. And then instead of 10 here, what you have here is 11.5, because this is the final layer and you need that 1 inch to fold it. So, and then you need only half an inch for this top part here, right? You need only half an inch at the line above, and then you need 1 inch complete to fold it instead of half an inch. So that's how you're going to do it for the length. But for the waist, let's say your waist is 20, that's the waist of the bodice that you're using to attach it, the waist of your, like your normal waist, where this dress, where this whole bottom part will attach to the top bodice is 20. What you're going to do is, for the first layer, you multiply it by 1.5, like I said in my previous video. Someone, that's why I said to leave all your comments or questions on the previous video, but I didn't get a lot of questions, so I will take it that you guys understood it. The only question I got was someone was asking me, why am I using 1.5? You can use two, you can use three, you can use whatever you want if you have the fabric to do that. But normally people just use 1.5, because that, if you start to use, let imagine using 2 to multiply this, that means you want the flare to go round 2 times of like the previous number you're using. So that means you're going to cut 40. So that means you're going to, because remember, this 1.5 applies to just when you're calculating the weight. So if I decide to use like 2 inches to multiply it now, that means my flare will go round, I need 2 times of this 20 to go round 2 times. So that's like 40. But if I decide to use 1.5 now, that means I'll use 30. So you see, it's less width of fabric. Like, I mean, width, meaning like less width is what I'm going to use here, right? But less, okay, that means I'm going to bring down this 40 again for my second layer. Because remember, whatever you get from the first layer, you bring it down to the second layer. And then you decide to use the same 2 again for the second layer, right? Because whatever you start with is what you're going to continue with now. So you decide to use this, that means you're going to get 80. But if I was using my 30, that is 1.5, that I'm multiplying it with, that means if I do 30 again, that will be 60, right? Times 1.5. And then you continue and you see how many layers you still have to go through. That's a lot of fabric. So that's why you normally use 1.5 to multiply each layer. So I'm going to just tell you guys how you're going to do it. So guys, like I said in my previous video, all you have to do now, so I'm going to just say it again. So to calculate yours, let's say your waist is 20, all you have to do is 1.5. That's times 1.5. Let's say you get 30. You bring down that 30 again. This is when you're calculating your width. You bring down that 30 again. This is your second layer. First layer, second layer, and then you're going to have your third layer and your fourth layer, right? So you're going to bring that 30 and multiply it by 1.5. So let's say you get 45. So guys, I'll get 45. So then you take that 45 again, bring it down to your third layer. This, and then that means you're going to multiply it with another 1.5. That means you have 67.5. right? And then you take that 67.5 and then you multiply it again. With 1.5, and then that's going to give you 94.5, right? So that means, like, how many times you need, if you're working with 5 layers, that's how you're going to calculate everything. So you're just going to keep going down with 1.5 extra, 1.5 extra. If you're going to do 5, 6, 7, 8 layers, any layer you need, this is how you're going to just be calculating how much rectangular width of fabric you need. We've already calculated how you're going to get the length, right? So that's basically it. So now I'm going to calculate mine and cut out everything I need for my layer. I'm not going to be using 4 layers like the thumbnail. I'm going to be doing 3 layers because I don't want my dress to be maxi. But I explained to you guys how it's going to be if you want yours to be 4 layers. Mine is going to be 3 layers and it's just below my knee. But if you want that extra layer, you can go further down and add yours. So guys, as you can see, I've gone ahead and joined my 3 layers. So, and as you can see, the last one was folded. And you're supposed to, you see, I have, because this is a Akara fabric, you don't have enough weight. So that's why mine, you see where I joined most of them. But all you have to do is just open up your seams this way and iron it. It will look like, it won't show any bulk once you iron it open this way. That's the secret to joining your fabric. Just iron it down this way and it will feel very smooth. So guys, as you can see, I've joined everything and then I only have one part left. So this part here is going to be my center front, where my placket of my button will come in. But before then, we'll go ahead and finish up our top. And to finish up our top, all we have to do is to go ahead and put in the dart. So to put in the dart, all you have to do is just to measure your nipple to nipple measurement, divide it by 2. So for me, that's 8 divided by 2 is going to be, I'm going to measure from this end to here and mark the 4 inches. And then I'm going to measure from my shoulder. Remember, this is my back panel, right? Measure from my shoulder to my chest line, which is somewhere here. So my dart is going to go up all the way to this point here and connect it. And then mark 1/2 inch on each side and then connect my dart. Just basically just how you're going to do it. And then that same 4 inches I marked here, I'm going to extend it to the front. But in front, my dart is going to stop 1 inch before my bust line. So my shoulder to bust is about 11 inches. So my dart is going to stop 12 inches. So 1 inch before my bust. So that's it here. So I'm going to take that 4 inches up, that line up here, and mark 1/2 inch on each side, and then narrow it down. So that's basically how you put in your dart. So you see, this is my front panel, the one that is into 2. So we'll go ahead and join this, put in my dart, and then to cut my sleeve. So guys, to cut my sleeve, I'm just going to measure around my armhole here. You're going to remove 1/2 inch here because you joined the shoulder. So, and then measure what is left. So for me, what is left for me is about, so it's about 10.5. So I'm going to come down here and put in my sleeve cap at 4 inches from the top part to this part here. And then I'm going to go ahead and mark my sleeve, what I measured now, which is 10.5. And I'm going to put it, mark it here. And then the next thing is to put in your tape this way from this point to this angle in a straight line. And then you find the center. So for me, that's going to be 11 is what I have at this point. So half of it is going to be 5.5. So from this point, you're going to give it a curve this way and also give it a curve at the top. So that's basically how you mark your sleeve. And then you put in your sleeve width, your arm width divided by 2 plus 1. So whatever you get, you're going to go ahead and put and fix that in here and then connect these 2 lines together. So that is basically it. I'm going to go ahead and cut this out. Just to go ahead, join my bodice, put the sleeve, and then join the gather to the bottom here. Join the skirt part to this. So as you can see, on this side, I still have the free end here. So basically, this is the part where I put in my button placket. So you see, this one is done already. This is because I want to use a different color. If you want, you can still use the color of your fabric. It doesn't matter. But I'm using a different color for this here and also the neckline. So I'm using a different color. So this is how you're going to do it. There are 2 ways to doing this. You can go ahead, measure out 3 inches of width and then fold it into 2, tucking 1/2 inch on each end, right? Tucking 1/2 inch on each end and then take it and put it in between this way. Like you're going to iron it, fold it into 2 first, iron the 2 ends 1/2 inch in, and then start this way. Just tuck this one in by 1/2 inch and then sew it all the way down. If you want to do that method. But the method me I'm using here is just I just cut the same 3 inches here, folded it into 2 this way, ironed it down. So and then I'm going to just take it this way and sew it down. You see, place it this way on top of this here and sew it all the way down. And then after, imagine after sewing it down, then I just flip it this way. So you see, this one was this way and then I sewed it down. So this way, just take it, place it on top of your fabric and sew it down. And then after sewing it down, you can push it back this way and iron it. And when you iron it, all your seam will be inside here. You can go ahead and top stitch it. You see all my seams here from when I attached it. So after that, you just flip it over and then you can go ahead and top stitch it here. So I'm going to do that on the 2 sides and then I'm going to show you guys how to put in the color. So guys, as you can see, I've also put this one, but I've not ironed this side. It still looks the same. So you see, I just have to go ahead, iron it and top stitch it. But this is what it will look like. You see, if I move everything to the end and the 2 of them will just overlap each other. So that's going to be my placket for the button. So the next thing I'm going to do now is to move this aside. But before that, you're going to go ahead and measure around your neck. So you're going to start from one end here and measure around the neck out the other end here. So that's what I've done. And then this is what I got. I got 19.5, right? So that 19.5, you're going to, whatever you got, you're going to add 1 inch to it. And then when you add 1 inch to it, the width of the collar I'm using, I already have a video on how to attach collar, but I'm just going to be using the simple method here. There are two methods to do that. I'm using the simple one here. So my width here is 7 inches. And then I folded it, ironed it down. So that's what to do. The length I have here is like 24. So whatever you get around the neck, right, you're going to add maybe, let's say, extra like 3 inches or 4 inches to it. And then so that you can be able to angle the end. So whatever you get, add extra 3 inches or 4 inches to it. So let's say I added extra 4 inches to mine, and then that's why mine is 24 inches. And then you're going to go ahead, fold it into two and mark the center. After marking the center, you open it up and spread it wide. And then whatever you get that I said that you should divide by, add plus one and then divide by two, you're going to find the middle of that, which is going to be here for me. And then I'm going to place that center somewhere here, and then I'm going to mark it at the end here, and then at the end here. So this is going to be my center. And then that 20.5 that I got, that's my 19.5 plus 1. I folded my tape into two this way, and then I split it open. At that point of the fold, I'm going to mark whatever I got halfway through and then halfway through here. So that's to split that measurement into two. And then after that, you're going to just connect that extra 4 inches you added. Is just for you to be able to give that angle that comes with your collar. So you see, I have extra like 2 inches here and the extra 2 inches at that end. So you're going to angle it to this point, and then you're also going to angle this one to this point. And then what you're going to do is you're going to go ahead and cut it off, right? You're going to go ahead and chip that off, and then chip this one off too. So guys, this is where that half an inch that 1 inch that you added to your round neck comes in, because you're going to use half an inch of seam allowance to join this end, right? Half an inch of seam allowance to join this end, and another half an inch of seam allowance to join this end. That's why you split it into two, so that each one will get half an inch and the same sides on both sides. So you're going to go ahead and close these two together now. So guys, I closed it up on the right side. So now all you have to do is to flip it back again to the right side. So the stitch was made on the wrong side, right? So now you're going to flip it over again. Make sure you bring out all the ends. And then how you're going to attach your collar is to go ahead and tuck in half an inch. You know how we did on this here, you tucked in half an inch like this, right? So that's what you're going to do. You're going to go ahead, tuck in half an inch, starting from this end here, tuck in half an inch here. Like hold it down, and then you're going to take your collar. You're going to start from one end, right? Like this. You're going to fix this in between after you've tucked in that half an inch on each end, and then you're going to go ahead, take it this way, place it on your sewing machine and start sewing it at the very end. So this is going to go in between this here, in between this opening of your collar, right? But you're going to use half an inch on each side of the collar to fold it. So you're going to go ahead and join everything together, and you're going to stitch it all the way till you get to the other end of the collar. And then you go ahead and put in your button and your button hole. So that's basically how you're going to do it. So guys, this is what it looks like. So I've finished mine, and as you can see, I've put in my button and the button hole. But for the bottom part, I decided to just close it up all the way half through here. So you see what it looks like here. So this is basically it here. So thank you guys so much for watching. Please like, share, and subscribe. Bye.